How much vitamin D we should get is one of the most controversial areas in the field of nutrition. Up until recently, the Institute of Medicine, the official body that sets the recommended daily allowances, considered 200 international units a day an adequate intake for those in middle age, but just bumped it up to a recommended 600 a day. How did they come up with the original 200? Why did they go up to 600? And why are there some experts out there saying we should take thousands a day? It all started with this line, written more than a half century ago. Apparently, a dosage of only 100 units of vitamin D daily was sufficient to prevent the flagrant signs and symptoms of rickets, the bow-legged bone-softening disease caused by overt vitamin D deficiency. From a review last year, the fact that 100 units of vitamin D prevented overt signs of rickets led to the false security that ingesting twice this amount was more than adequate to satisfy the body's vitamin D requirement, hence the 200 recommendation, but no longer. The Institute of Medicine decided to take a more scientific approach by basing their recommendations on a specific target blood level, which they calculated to be 20 nanograms per milliliter, which should prevent rickets in children and a similar bone-softening condition called osteomalacia in adults. To get most people's levels up to 20, though, the Institute of Medicine figured it would require about 600 IUs a day, and so the recommendation was officially bumped up. At the Institute of Medicine's new target of 20 in the blood, right now, 40% of Americans are vitamin D deficient. And if we use higher cutoffs, say 30, then that proportion climbs to more than three-quarters of our population. Is there a way we can ask the body how much vitamin D it wants overall? Scientists came up with two ways. First, let's say you give a whopping dose, and I mean whopping, 100,000 units, something that could be toxic if done on a daily basis. The question is, what's our body's saturation point? Of this massive dose, how much does our body actually use, and how much does it sock away in storage for use later on down the road? Here's the graph. 30 people followed for 4 months after the megadose. Here's the flood of D coming into their system, but the solid circles represent the pool of vitamin D our body is keeping in our bloodstream for activation, and the rest is likely stored away to be used on an as-needed ongoing basis. Note that in this setting of abundance, the body is keeping our levels right around that sweet spot dip found in the U-shaped mortality curve. You can do the same thing at the other end of the spectrum, too. Instead of a megadose, you can start by giving really tiny doses and gradually kind of working your way up. When you do that, you get a graph like this, showing a so-called biphasic pattern, really steep at first, but then leveling out. When you take in just a little bit, your body zips it into circulation, desperately needing it. But then, as you increase the dose, at a certain point you kind of turn the corner when the crisis is averted. Your body seems happy enough with your levels that as you take more in, your levels still rise, but it's not such an emergency. Now, if this plateau was flat, completely horizontal, then there'd be no risk of toxicity. But because your body can't help but let some in, your levels continue to rise with increasing intake, and you can run into vitamin D toxicity problems if we take too much. But what's this level here, kind of right at the corner where your body takes a big sigh of relief that you're doing pretty good on vitamin D? Well, kind of working in from both ends, the level at which our body appears satisfied translates to about 2,000 international units a day, which should get us right into that U-shaped longevity sweet spot. Whereas the Institute of Medicine recommendation appears too low, and the 10,000 recommendation put forth by others appears too high.